to the concert itself. So we decided that we were also going to showcase some of the visual arts. We're really excited to bring that to you. And we'll talk a little bit about that later, but I just want to introduce the band and say that the very first song we played tonight was Rock Around the Clock. And our next song is a song that was made popular by the Beatles, by John Lennon and Paul McCartney, Yesterday.
Thank you all for out, and that's what today was, is it all about. So we thought, why not collaborate with the music department and include some visual arts? So here you'll see we have some three-dimensional art on the tables. We have some two-dimensional art on the easels, and we will later have some digital photography being shown on the screen while there is music playing in the background and was created by those students. And Ms. Campbell will talk a little bit more about that. You might be wondering what's happening over here. We have Thomas doing a performance piece. And so he is using today's theme of time. For the concert's theme is time. And he's using that as inspiration to create a painting while the concert's taking place. So there'll be a reveal at the end of the concert. And enjoy the show.
And thank you for mentioning it, because my brain is in a million places. But today's theme of the concert is about time, because we are celebrating the centennial of Church Farm School. So we thought it would be a really great idea to tie in a bunch of different songs from different eras that are based around the theme of time. So the next song that we have for you is a song made popular by the musical Hairspray. It was written for Hairspray, and it's called You Can't Stop the Beat.
Thank you.
have a song called Take Five. And if you don't know this song, it's quite a challenge for any younger group. In music, most times, when we're first learning music, and a lot of the music we listen to is in a time signature called 4-4. So that means that you can count to four over and over again, and it fits really, really well with what you're listening to, okay? So we are playing a song called Take Five, and it's got five beats in a measure instead of four. So it's really an adjustment if you've never played or listened to music in a different time signature before. But this has been our challenge piece, and I think it might be our favorite one now that we've done it too much. So enjoy. Senior Giampi, who's just on the drum set, and studied a lot of musical genres in the Western culture, in American culture over the 20th century. We talked about how technology allowed music to evolve and become what it is today. And we talked about different and unique elements of each genre of music. So his is based off of kind of like a country pop vibe. So you'll hear that. The second piece is by former band member, I don't know if you see him right now, Angelina Go. Do you know her either? Oh, he went out. That's okay. So Gino's piece, you'll hear it. It's a really wonderful piece. We talked about layers and textures in music. And music is made up of many different sounds. It's not just one thing the whole time. So his piece really talks about layers and textures. And we also worked with chord progressions, which is a pretty advanced part of music theory if you've never read music before. And Gino has, but many of the students in the class have not. So that is going to be the second song that you hear. And the third song you hear this evening is a song done by Kareem Lewis Raw, and I know he's here. I just saw him a little bit ago. He's back there. Kareem, you saw some of the storybook compositions as you walked in. In Music Tech 1, we talked about form in music. So most of the music we listen to on the radio and pop music has a form where there's a verse and a chorus. And sometimes a bridge, and then it all kind of comes back. So we demonstrated our understanding of form by picking children's storybooks and creating a song out of them. So his is based off of One Fish, Two Fish, Red Fish, Blue Fish. So I hope you enjoy, and I hope you also enjoy the artwork.
Thank you. Some are holy, some are guilty. Some are sad, some are glad. Some are very, very dead. Are they sad, yeah, dead? I don't know, they're actually dead. Some are good, and some are bad. Depending on how they go ahead. From here to there, from there to here. When you think about everywhere, I'm on this stupid head. There's something like the fun, but the fun, I suck. Oh my, with a lot of funny things go by. Some have 2 feet, some have 4, some have 6 feet, some have 4. Where they come from, I can't say, that they come from a long, long way. Beasts can come, beasts can go, some are bad, some are slow, some are high, some are low. Now what it's like to know, but that's so fine, I'll ask you what to say. Look, that's good, 1, 2, 3, how many fingers do I see?
100% student made. We do use a loop-based software to make those compositions. So songs that Curry made, we had some pre-made GarageBand loops that were in there. But for the Music Tech 2 projects, the first two that you heard, Gino and Senior did not use a single pre-made loop. They did all that on their own. that song is called Clocks, and it is by the band Coldplay. The next song we have up isn't necessarily a song named after the theme of time, but I thought it was really important to add this song. I have some members of my band who have been with me for a very long time, and their time is coming to an end. So I've got some four-year band members here. I've got HJ, who's been with me since his ninth grade year. Got Cyrus, who's been with me since his ninth grade year. And Saeed, who couldn't take class, but he's been at band club and he's been a great help. I've had him since his ninth grade year. Junior and senior brothers, I've had them since they've been here too, right? Yep. So I've had those guys. And I didn't forget about the last two, but I've had two members in this band that I've had since the seventh grade, and I'm really sad to say goodbye to all of you, but I've seen these guys grow up a lot. So Abednego and John Lee, I've had them since seventh grade. Don't You Worry About a Thing. It's a Stevie Wonder tune, and it's just a reminder to these guys that, you know, even though they're leaving this place, we're always going to be here for you guys. It's for you. Thank you. But I just want to thank you once again for coming out and supporting all of the arts here at Church Farm School. Keep them alive. Next weekend is the choir concert. Really looking forward to that. And if you think you should come, happy Mother's Day again to all of the mothers out there and to all of the females who work here at Church Farm School who are mothers, for people who are far away from their moms. So before we play our last piece for you, I know it's still a work in art here, but I'm going to ask Thomas to turn his painting around and show us what he's done so far. Thank you again for coming.